Hi, this is Shiva Rajaya from vitalcoaching.com. We are talking about mastering her shadows, mastering female shadows. And the topic for this specific video is why mastering or honoring her shadows expands your energetic or emotional potential. So let's talk about emotions, okay? You've got positive, beautiful emotions, and you have the shadow emotions, which are more like what we would call negative, but negative is not the right word. So let's call them simply shadow emotions. So when you are in the presence of another human being, there is a certain range of emotions that you are comfortable with, okay? And you can call that the energetic or emotional potential that you have with that person. And most of the times in relationships, especially in the romantic period that might last anywhere between 1 to 6 months, where you are not fighting, where everything is okay, there are, you know, not too many complications, during that time you are going to build up romantic energy and harmony and beauty and love and all these beautiful energies and emotions. And so while you are in that time, this is a really beautiful thing because you are there and you are being nurtured. And then kicks in after a few months or after a few weeks, then you have the first fight, the first disagreement, the first place where there is energetic dissonance. And then at that moment, you can go like, wow, you know, looks like we are not made for each other because we are not perfect and because we are fighting now. And you go like, no, you don't have to separate. You don't have to take distance because of that. You can stay in each other's presence and realize that what you are doing right now is exploring and conquering the shadows together. And so when you honor a woman's shadow, what you are doing is like you're literally saying yes to the energetic and emotional potential that you can access in that field. I can give you a metaphor. For instance, if you live in a country, right, and you are close to the beach and all these beautiful beaches, and then you have some tropical jungle not too far away, and you go like, wow, I don't want to go there because you have snakes and scorpions and wild animals and maybe alligators or, you know, other animals or insects. And you go like, wow, you know, one day you wake up and you say, you know what, I'm not going to have a full relationship with this island or with this tropical place unless I go and face what's in this jungle. And so you decide to go into it, into an exploration. And in the process of doing that, magic is going to take place because you realize that you are going to conquer a new energetic or, you know, emotional environment, a new natural environment. One of the things that you want to do as a human being is learn how to master energetic or emotional environments. This is what we are training ourselves to do. You want to learn how to be comfortable in the jungle, in the ocean, in urban environments. And when it comes to interpersonal relationships, one of the places that we would love to conquer is romantic relationships. It's being able to be in the presence of a woman as a man, you know, and for women in the presence of men, and be completely present and be able to access all the wide range of possible emotions that are right there. So why do you want to honor female intensity if it's unpleasant for your system? Because your system is going to learn how to adapt to that. It's going to learn how to dive into these emotions without freaking out. And what is going to happen in the process of doing that is that you are going to access resources of energy that are really powerful. Because, for instance, an intense emotion like anger or frustration, it's fire, it's friction, it's energy. And so if instead of pushing that away, you go like, no, stay away from me with that emotion. You go like, okay, bring it on. It looks like there is fire. Let's play with fire. You know, you honor that emotion. Process of doing that, suddenly with your partner, with your lover, suddenly you have this space that you can play with. You go like, wow, we are learning how to play with fire. And so it's a really interesting thing to do. It's a really powerful thing to do. You suddenly know how to go into intensity with her and expand yourself within that space. And it's going to boost the power and the potential of your relationship to be able to deal and be in intensity together. You get that? This is the reason why when intensity or shadows, emotions come out in your relationship. Instead of being like blocking them and suppressing them and pushing them away, you can go like, bring them on. Come on, come on. Bring it. I'm ready. I know how to take it. And I know how to play with that. So it's not necessarily forcing them or inviting them by force, okay? The idea is simply that. It's like you can play with a wide range of emotions and be comfortable with it. And be a little bit like a ninja, right? Energetic, emotional ninja. Somebody comes with an attack, you go, oh, took. Let me see, let me change perspective. Let me have sympathy for that emotion and see how I can learn how to master my own energetic emotional reaction to that degree of intensity. Makes sense, right? This is beautiful stuff. I love you. I'll see you soon.